Hello dear students, and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson body movement, and in that today we will start the next point from the same lesson, that is locomotion in animals. Okay, so like a human being, animals are also showing the locomotion, but the way to show the locomotion is different. So let's see how the different animals are showing the locomotion. First we will go through the earthworm. Let's discuss how the earthworm is showing the locomotion. So as we know, an earthworm has a long cylindrical body made up of rings or segments joined end to end. Okay, so see here in the image, it is the one type of the diagram of earthworm. So these earthworms are having the small segment like body. Okay, these parts are joined to each other. This each part is called as what? Segments. And these segments are connected to each other. Okay, so the earthworm is having the segmented body, many rings or segment join end to end. And very important is that the earthworm has a liquid skeleton which helps in maintenance of body shape. So now liquid skeleton means what? In our previous point we have discussed about the human skeleton or the skeletal system. It means what? Different bones are present in the human body, but in the earthworm's body there are no any bones. Instead of the bone, they are having the liquid. Their whole body is filled of liquid, and that is the reason we can say that what, the earthworm has a liquid skeleton, and that liquid skeleton helps the maintenance of the body shape. Okay, so what is the function of the skeleton? We have seen the skeleton gives us shape to the body, help us to move the body. So in this way, the same functions performed by the liquid skeleton in the earthworm is that what? It helps to maintain the shape of the body. Next one, on the undersurface body, the number of minute bristles are present that help the earthworm get a firm grip on the ground. Muscles attached to these bristles helps to contract the body. Okay, so under surface of the body, under surface or at the downside portion of the earthworm, there are the bristles or the hair like structure, we can say that, and that hair like structures are called as what? Bristles. Now what is the use of this bristle? So with the help of the bristles, the earthworm can firmly keep the contact of its body to the ground, or it can helps to grip, firm grip on the surface. Okay, and these bristles are having the muscles. Okay, bristles are connected to the muscles, and that muscles helps the earthworm to move its body. So see here, the earthworm gets a firm grip on the ground. Muscles attached to these bristles helps to contract the body, and to these bristles there are the certain muscles are present that bristle, and with the help of that muscles the earthworm can do the movement. Okay, so in the human body we have seen that in the muscular system, with the help of the contraction and the relaxation, we can do the movement of the different joints. Like that, with the help of the muscles, same as in the human body, in the earthworm also we can say that with the help of the contraction and the relaxation of the muscles, the earthworm can do the locomotion. Now let's see movement of earthworm. Okay, so see here is the diagram. This is the earthworm, this is the front portion of the earthworm, this is the back portion, these are the minute hair like structure which we are calling as what? Bristles. These are the rings or the segments of the earthworm's body. Next one is that here you can see in the image that in this B image, what we can say that the front position or the front part of the earthworm is leave the ground, and its segments or the rings are long and thin. Okay, long and thin. Why is it like that? Let's see why the like this structure is shown by the earthworm. Next one, what we can say that There are two types of muscles in an earthworm's body. So there are the two types of the muscles are present in an earthworm's body, that are circular and longitudinal muscle. Two types of the muscles, that are what? Circular muscles and longitudinal muscles. So very important point is this, what? When the circular muscles contract, the segments become long and thin. Okay, so when the circular muscles get contract, then the segments become how? Long and thin. Next one, when longitudinal muscles contract, that time segments how? The segments become short and thick. So when circular muscles contract, segments become long and thin. When longitudinal muscles contract, the segments become short and thick. Okay, up to here clear? Next one, so the earthworms move by lengthening and the shortening of the body segments with the help of the circular and longitudinal muscle. So in the previous some lines we have discussed that with the help of the muscles the earthworm can do the locomotion, but how? With the help of the contraction and the relaxation of the circular and the longitudinal muscles, the earthworms is showing the movement. So because of that contraction and the relaxation of what happened, the earthworm's body becomes lengthening and the shortening. Okay, the earthworm's body become get increase in the length and get decrease in the length. That is what? Lengthening and the shortening of the body segments with the help of the circular and longitudinal muscles. So the keywords we can say that what? Two types of the muscles are present in the earthworm's body, circular and longitudinal. Circular muscles contract, that time the segments become long and thin. Longitudinal muscles contract, that time segments become short and thick. And with the help of this contraction of these muscles, the earthworm is showing the movement. Now let's see how exactly the earthworm is showing the movement with the help of these muscles. So to move, first the earthworm contracts the circular muscles of the front segment. So now let's observe the figure A. So what we can see in the figure A, for first time what happened? The front part, first the earthworm contracts the circular muscle from the front portion. It contracts the circular muscles from the front portion. See here we can see that the segments become what? Long and thin. Okay, the segments become long and thin. Now the next one we can say that, so the first earthworm contracts the circular muscle of the front segment. As a result, the front part of the body becomes how? Long and moves a little ahead, withdrawing the bristles from the ground. So from the front position, the circular muscles get contract, and that is the reason the segments become what happened? The segments become how? Long and thin. Okay, as a result, the front part of the body becomes long, and that time what happened? The bristles withdraw from the ground, and the earthworms can move its body little ahead. It takes its body little front. Okay, so first here what we can say that, see here, so this is A diagram. Here we can say that the circular muscles are contract, and that is the reason the front portion becomes long. Okay, and here we can say that the front portion, because of the contraction of the circular muscles, become long, and here we can also see that they withdraw the bristles and little push its body ahead. Okay, next one. Now what happened? Then what happened? The longitudinal muscles of the front part of a earthworm contracts, and the segments become short and thick. Now what will happen? The longitudinal muscles, but in which part? From the front part only. The longitudinal muscles of the front parts of the earthworm get contracts, and the segments become short and thick. That time what happened? The bristles of the front part now grip the ground. Now what happened? when the longitudinal muscles from the front part of the earthworm's body get contracts, then what happens? The segments become short and thick, and that time the bristles again grip the ground. And next one, what happens? And the segments in the rear part of the earthworms become thin and long due to the contraction of the muscles. Then if the here we can see that the diagram C. Okay, so now what happened? This is the front portion we have seen. That in that what happened? The circular muscles are contract and they the bristles lose the grip from the ground and little bit of body of the earthworms get ahead. Now what happens? Now from this front portion, what happened? The longitudinal muscles get contract. Okay, here we are observing the figure C. Now from this what happened? The longitudinal muscles get contract, and that is the reason the body becomes how long? The body becomes short and thick. And that time what happened? From the front side only what happened? The bristles again grip the ground. And that same time what happened? The remaining portion or the back side rear portion what happened? In this portion what happened? The circular muscles get contract, bristles withdraw from the ground, and the body becomes how long and thin. Okay, long and thin, and again this body portion get ahead. Okay, next one, in this way, by doing all this contraction and the relaxation, next the rear part of the earthworms become short and thick due to contraction of longitudinal muscle. So in this way the earthworm moves a small distance ahead. So in this way the earthworm moves a small distance ahead. So what we can say that from the front portion, first the circular muscles get contract, with the help of that the bristles lose the grip from the ground and push the body parts ahead. That time the backside portion of the earthworms become grip the ground properly with the help of the bristles. And that time next one what happened? When the front side portion lose the grip, backside bristles hold the grip properly to the ground. Okay, with the help of the contraction of the circular muscles and the longitudinal muscles, the earthworm is move ahead with the short distance. Okay, so when the muscles get circular muscles get contract, they lose the grip from the ground and push its body ahead. And when the longitudinal muscles get contract, that time again the bristles hold the grip on the surface, and backside portion again moves forward. So in this way, what we have to keep in the mind? So with the help of the contraction of the circular muscles and the longitudinal muscles, the earthworms is showing the locomotion. So this is the locomotion about the, this is the locomotion of earthworm. See here, very important point is that the exoskeleton of an animal present outside its body is called exoskeleton. So the skeleton of an animal present outside the body, generally what we are discuss up till now, the skeleton is present inside the body, but there are the certain animals that animals showing the skeleton outside its body, and that skeleton is called as exoskeleton. Now exo means what? Outside. That's why what? Exoskeleton. Examples we can say that what? Snails, cockroaches, crabs have exoskeleton. They are having a very tough cover on their body. That is only we are calling as what? Exoskeleton. The skeleton of an animal present inside its body is called endoskeleton. Endo means what? Inside. So the skeleton, the animals also having the skeleton inside their body, that skeleton is called as what? Endoskeleton. So many examples we'll get in the endoskeleton. Humans, fishes, amphibians, reptiles and birds have the endoskeleton. Now amphibians means what? The animal, those who can live in water also and on the land also. Reptiles means what? Those who crawl on the ground. And the birds, all these are having what? Endoskeleton. Exoskeleton is found in fish and reptiles in the form of scale. In birds, It is found in the form of feathers and in mammals in the form of nails and hair. So this exoskeleton is also shown by the fish in the and the reptiles in the form of what? Scales. So as we know, in the body of the fish and the reptiles there are the scales. So that is nothing but what? Exoskeleton. In the bird, the exoskeleton is formed in the form of feathers, and in mammals like human being, it is in the form of nails and hair. So this is about exoskeleton and endoskeleton. Now next one we will discuss about the how the snail is showing the locomotion. So the snails have a hard shell on their back that protect them from heat and enemies. So that snails, as we have seen, the snails is having the hard covering on its body, which helps the snail to protect itself from the heat and the enemies. Snails have a large flat foot made up of strong muscles. The foot produces a slimy substance called mucus. So see here, the snail is having one flat foot, and that flat foot is, we can call as what? Muscular foot. And this muscular foot continuously secreted the mucus, which helps to decrease the friction between the surface and the foot. Okay, so the foot produces a slimy substance called mucus, which reduces the friction between the foot and the ground surface. The muscles of the foot enables the snail to move forward, and there are the very strong muscles present in the foot which helps the snail to move forward. And if you have observed sometime, if the snail is moving on any surface, then backside we can see the one trail of the mucus, or we can see the one line of the water. That watery substance that is nothing but what? Mucus. So the trail of mucus is left behind when the snail crawl. Okay, see here, this is what? Trail of mucus. Okay, next one. A trail of mucus is left behind when the snail crawl. The shell does not help in moving from place to place, it to be dragged alone. Okay, so in the snail, the shell does not help in moving from place to place, but it has to be carried, or it has to be dragged along its body. So this is about what? Snail is having the strong muscular foot, which is called as what? That is long muscular foot, which secreted the slimy substance, that is what? Mucus, which reduced the friction. Okay, so with the help of that foot, or the with the help of that muscular foot, the snail is showing the locomotion. Now the next one we will see that locomotion in cockroach. So the cockroaches have three pair of joint legs and strong muscles to pull these legs. Okay, so the cockroaches are having the three pairs of legs. It means what? Totally how many legs? Six legs and three pairs, we can say that. Cockroaches have three pairs of joint legs and strong muscles to pull these legs. So that legs are joined to the muscles, which helps to pull these legs. Joint legs and the strong muscles helps them to walk and run. So these legs and the muscle joined to that legs helps the cockroach to walk and to run. Their feet have tiny claws that help them climb on walls. So in the image you can see that these are the claws, okay, and that claws helps the cockroach to run or to climb on wall. Their feet have tiny claws, so these claws helps the cockroaches to climb on walls. Cockroaches have two pairs of wings. So we have seen the cockroach many times. Then the cockroaches can fly, but they cannot fly the very high distance. They can fly only the short distance with the help of their two wings. And now only we have discussed that the outer hard exoskeleton of cockroach is made up of different parts. So the cockroach is having what? Exoskeleton, which is having the different parts, and that parts helps in the movement of the body. The different parts of the exoskeleton helps to move the body place to place. Cockroaches have a pair of antenna. You can see here the cockroach is having the pair of antenna, and that antenna helps to smell the things, and a pair of cerci that can detect even a very small slight movement. And that is the reason if you walk very slowly, then also the cockroaches can come to know that something danger is there, and they can run away. Okay, so in this way, with the help of that cerci, they can detect even very slight movement. So see here, we can see that with the help of this diagram, how they exactly cockroach is showing the locomotion. So as we know, there are the three pairs of legs, means totally six legs are there. So the opposite number of the legs gives the support, and the remaining opposite pairs moves the body. So see here, leg 1, 3 and 5. This supports the body, while 2, 4, 6 move the body front. Okay, so odd number of the legs supports the body, and that time even number of the legs helps to move the body. But in the next position, what happened? The legs which were given the support, now that legs will helps to move, and the legs which were helps to move the body, now they will give the support. So now here see, 2, 4 and 6 supports the body, while 1, 3 and 5 move the body. So in this way, cockroaches is showing the movement with the help of using the three legs to the support and three legs to the movement. So this is all about the locomotion in earthworm, snail and cockroaches. This is all about today. We will discuss the remaining parts in the next video. And for today, thank you.